New tear down in the lab today. This is a high voltage power supply. I believe this is pronounced Acopian. This is a 10 kilovolt power supply. I believe this one's rated at 6 milliamps according to the part number. This seems to be still manufactured. I got this on a swap for a Tektronix scope that I was no longer using. It's a pretty impressive bit of hardware. It's extremely heavy. Looks to be very well built. Relatively easy to work on. If you look here at the back, it has the AC input here as terminals. If I do end up repairing this or verifying that it works, I'm actually going to change this out to something a little more usable. I have a rack mount that I'll install this in, and I try to keep any kind of AC voltages or any high voltage exposed in the back of the rack. Pretty obvious, here's the standard disclaimer. This is a high voltage device. You want to be very careful. If you don't know a lot about high voltage, steer clear of this, watch the video, enjoy it. This particular unit has programmable current and voltage. You can control that here. There are a set of jumpers. I believe this is installed for local control. I'll verify that with the installation data sheet that I have. But you can actually control this from remotely via these terminals, where it has these really nice veneer controls. They're locking. You can lock the settings. And overall, it's just a really nice looking unit. I know it's hard to describe, but just everything from handles are solid, and the case is very well built. It just is a really nice piece of equipment. So we'll get into it. I just want to do a couple of checks. I have not tried to power this unit on yet. I'm going to tear into it and just make sure there's nothing obvious wrong before I really do anything with it. I'm fairly certain, as with most of these units, the high voltage section is actually sealed. Which basically means that I will likely get into that if I need to. But if I do that, I probably will never put this in service. If that section is good, from my understanding of what the docs, there's actually a control board in here that is user serviceable, and the high voltage module is not. But we'll just tear into it here and see what happens. Okay, a couple of the first checks I'm going to do is just some simple continuity checks to see if there's any obvious shorting. Okay, chassis ground appears to be grounded to the output return pin and to the chassis. So our ground looks good. And it doesn't appear that any of the AC inputs are shorted to ground. Okay, that's our programming ground and our signal ground. So our grounds look good. It doesn't appear anything's dead shorted that I can see. And our load neutral appears to be open. Yeah, we have a good fuse, and it's not blown. That's a good sign. Here's a peek inside the unit. I'm going to tilt this up so you can see. Very robust, well built. I really like how the case is put together. They've got these extruded sides, which basically hold the back. Just some small cover plates on the top and front. I'm assuming this provides plenty of adequate ventilation. If you look here, this is basically a, I don't know that it's the same type, but there's a HS10 connector, which is a high voltage connector. It looks a lot like a, you know, a radio RF style PL connector, but it actually goes back well into the device, I'm assuming providing maximum isolation into the device. Very large transformer here, the controls and meters. There's also another transformer. This appears to be the control modules. I see a few ICs. Another transformer module. And this, I believe, is the sealed high voltage module. It's completely potted, completely sealed. I don't think there would be any way of easily getting into that. More than likely that's a multiplier that you would normally see on one of these high voltage supplies. There's a really heavy duty switch here. So we're just going to do a couple more checks just to see what we have before we actually apply AC power. Okay, we're seeing about 2.6 ohms through the transformer with the switch on. Just wanted to verify again that we've got an open with the switch off. Okay. Okay, I don't see any damage that I would expect to see in one of these units. It looks really clean. I don't see anything that would stop me from actually powering this up and see if we can get some output on it. We'll see what happens. Okay, so currently we do see voltage. Okay, that should be about 2.5 kilovolts of power. And we're seeing about 315 volts DC, or 0.315 volts DC. Now I'm actually going to monitor the discharge. And it falls off rather rapidly after the first few seconds. So we're back at 0 volts. Okay, all we're going to try to do now is see if we can get some output at the multimeter. I basically inserted a screwdriver into the connector to bring the connection far enough out to where I could reach it. It's not the safest thing in the world. It will work. I don't recommend anybody ever try this. Also, I'm going to be keeping the voltage really, really low just to make sure that we don't create an arc, and see if we can get an output at the connector of a lower voltage than this, what this is rated at. Okay. Okay, we've got some voltage. Currently, we have 510 volts. I'm going to bring this up just a bit more. Okay, the control is responding with an up and down. I'm going back down now just to see how low this will actually go. Okay, we're down at about 59 volts DC. I'm not really sure or comfortable on these controls where they actually roll all the way back around. This one appears that it is going to. So basically, I just went down to the zero mark, or close to the zero mark, as I can get. It does appear that this works. I'm going to do a couple more experiments with it and actually put a load on it and see what we can get. And also do a little bit of research to figure out what kind of connector. I'm fairly certain I know which one it is, but I'll probably actually call these guys. This unit's still manufactured. It's made here in the U.S. So I should be able to get some information from them. I think they include by default an 8-foot or so cable. But if you needed to make a cable up on your own, like I say, all you need to do is get the proper connector. Usually those are a metal PL style outer and a insulator that goes really deep into the chassis. It actually goes all the way up, almost all the way up into the chassis and rests against the spring. Okay, I've got a semi-proper cable made and just going to do a quick test under load. I've got the current just minimal that should be around, it should be less than a milliamp. And I'm going to crank the voltage up to about 6 kV, 6 kilovolt DC, and we'll see if we can get an arc going in between these two alligator clips. Okay, it appears that it definitely, there's nothing wrong with this power supply. It works great. I'm really not sure what I'm going to use it for. I'm sure a use will come up at some point. But it's a great piece of gear. It's like I said, it's really well built, easy to use, and overall safe design. The only thing I really didn't like about it was the power connector. And I'm sure that's optional. I don't like a lot of gear that has manual input terminals for the AC. But I'm sure that this was designed to go in a permanent installation.